Father's Day to you all. And how many of you have had problems? Good. Be sure to give them thanks, and if they've passed on, say a prayer. Blessings to you all. This morning we have several things going on. We have the team from Lutherwood. We're going to be leading our vacation Bible school this week, and they are Theo, Meg, Jordan, and Nate. So we'll be seeing a lot of you this week. Glad you're here. We also will be commissioning the Mexico mission team, going to Mexico this coming Saturday, which is Friday. Saturday. And Chad came first service and second, so that's really good. We're going to send you to We also are commissioning the Vacation Bible School staff, so it's a very full and wonderful Sunday morning. I invite you to stand as we begin with the confession and forgiveness. You can answer that in just a moment. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the creator of wind and rain, field and ocean, the bread of life coming down from above, the power at work within us and this world.
Amen.
As we begin, before God and in the company of our sisters and brothers, we confess our sin. God and Father of all,
we confess that we have sinned against you, not in word or deed. We have thought better of ourselves than others. We have told lies, said hurtful things, acted in ways we wish we could take back, and looked the other way when action was needed. In your mercy, O God, forgive us, cleanse us, and heal us. For the sake of Jesus, our Savior.
God, who loves you dearly, forgives you all of your sin, raises you to new life in Jesus Christ, and renews you by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
sisters and brothers in Christ, beloved children of God, grace, mercy, and peace be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Sunshine and storm, by your strength pilot us, by your power preserve us, and by your wisdom instruct us, and by your hand protect us, through Jesus Christ our Savior and Lord.
Amen. A reading from the 38th chapter of Job. Then the Lord answered Job out of the whirlwind, "Who is this that darkens counsel by words without knowledge? Gird up your loins like a man. I will question you, and you shall declare to me. Where were you when I laid the foundation of the earth? Tell me, if you have understanding. Who determined its measurements? Surely you know. Or who stretched the line upon it? On what were its bases sunk? Or who laid its cornerstone when the morning stars sang together and all the heavenly beings shouted for joy? Or who shut in the sea with doors when it burst out from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling band and prescribed bounds for it and set bars and doors and said, thus far shall you come and no farther, and here shall your proud waves be stopped." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A reading from the 6th chapter of 2 Corinthians. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, "At an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you." See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way. Through great endurance in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing and yet possessing everything. We have spoken frankly to you, Corinthians. Our heart is wide open to you. There is no restriction in our affections, but only in yours. In return, I speak as to children, open wide your hearts also. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Said to the disciples, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. Other boats were with him. A great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But he was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And so they woke him up and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." Then the wind ceased and there was a dead calm. Jesus said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great awe, and they said to one another, "Who then is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him?" This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And you receive it. Children, women,
talk about one of the Bibles in the story. There are lots of Bibles.
Father's Day and welcome and celebrate our fathers. And I didn't know if you knew, but dads and moms tend to be different. They tend to parent differently. They tend to protect differently. And they teach differently. Moms tend to buy bumper pads. Dads tend to buy Band-Aids. Moms tend to schedule play dates. Dads sometimes encourage throwdowns. Often there seem to be different styles between moms and dads. Moms tend to say, you worried me so much. Dads tend to say, don't worry so much. Kids need both kinds of parenting. But it's a challenge, especially for single parents, to find a way or a person to bring in all the possibilities and probabilities that are part of the richness of having both a mom and a dad to engage the lives of their children. Being part of a church family, we can all bless our children. One of the ways, by sharing through Vacation Bible School, and personally, by getting to know kids' names. Not just, hey kid, but hey, Zane. Yeah, know their names. In doing that, we can personally care for all of our kids in special ways. I thank God for all moms and dads who offer this gift of confidence. A gift of conviction, a gift of risk and courage based on trust. These are gifts every child needs from someone. In the context of Jesus' culture, he loved like a mother and taught like a father. He did not have his disciples sit around in a yeshiva synagogue school learning Torah tidbits. Jesus took his disciples to work with him, to apprentice with him, so that they could learn by doing. Like all children, the disciples got it wrong, really, a lot of the time. That's why in Mark's gospel, the disciples are often called the duh disciples. Today's gospel lesson shows just how duh they could get. In our gospel lesson, it had been a long and exhausting day. Jesus and the disciples get in a boat and they start across the Sea of Galilee, heading out into open water. Jesus, being tired, conks out in the back, contentedly curled up on a cushion in the wind-sheltered stern of the boat. But a storm kicks up. Pretty soon the storm is kicking the boat all over the place. And yet, Jesus snoozes in his stern. Terrified, drenched, and despairing, the disciples pounce on Jesus and wake him up screaming, "Teacher, don't you care that we are drowning?" Shouted out of his sleep, Jesus might have keel-hauled his comrades, but he does not. There is no rebuke for the disciples waking him up. There is only a rebuke to the sea for disturbing the peace. Jesus walks to the side of the boat and calmly and confidently stills the storm. But imagine now that you are with me as some of the disciples in that boat. You've just witnessed one of the greatest miracles of Jesus' ministry. The first time he demonstrated his power over nature. Jesus, remember, had healed people before this, but there were a lot of wandering faith healers in Jesus' day. Here was a healer who could command the wind and the waves to obey him. If you and I are one of the disciples, I know what we're doing after that miracle. High-fiving it, baby. For the wisdom of our choice. Did we pick the right guy or what? You know, old so-and-so could never have done Jesus did. Are we good or what? High five. And then we would go on high-fiving everybody, maybe even body-slamming us, each other, carefully. What a blessing. Can you believe that we are the first to be there when Jesus did the impossible? Can you believe what we just saw? Are we blessed or what? We are the first to see Jesus performing the miraculous. What a privilege. What a blessing. We have just witnessed the greatest miracle in all of recorded history. And exactly right. Jesus turns around and says to us, the high-fiving, body-slamming disciples, right? He says, congratulations, disciples. You've just seen some of my best work. Wrong. What Jesus actually says, to use academic language, y'all get an F. Jesus says, disciples, you didn't pass the test. That's not the real thrill I had in mind for you. You could have ridden history's greatest roller coaster ride. With me in the boat and with the Holy Spirit billowing the sails, what do you have to fear? What harm can come to you? The disciples, however, settle for the lull of their lives rather than the ride of their lives. You know, the church loves to focus on Jesus' first rebuke to the storm, be still. We often forget Jesus' second rebuke to the little faith disciples. True, the rock didn't sink. Jesus is with us, right? So we can relax and we don't have to worry about storms. Yet one comes up, one always comes up. But what is our fear? We can talk to God through our stormy situations. We can ride the waves with peace and joy, and yeah, we can pass out the kites. Jesus does not promise us calm seas, but he does promise to calm us in every sea. Jesus doesn't promise to speak peace to every storm that comes our way, but he does promise to give us perfect peace even in the midst of the perfect storm. 21-year-old Dylan Storm Roof last Wednesday at a wonderful Bible study at Emmanuel AME Church in Charleston, South Carolina, participated in the Bible study for an hour. And then he shot 9 people dead. The 9 killed included Dr. Clementa Pinckney, who graduated in 2008 from the Lutheran Southern Seminary, plus 3 other pastors killed. Dr. Pinckney was head of the head pastor of the church and also a state senator. The others were coaches, teachers, a librarian, counselors, choir singers, and the elderly custodian who kept Emmanuel Church clean. At his first court hearing, several relatives of those killed spoke to Dylan Roof via video. Alana Simmons, whose grandfather, Pastor Daniel Simmons, died, said, although my grandfather and the other victims died at the hands of hate, this is proof. Everyone's plea for your soul is proof that they lived in love and their legacies will live in love so hate won't win. Felicia Sanders survived by pretending to be dead, but she lost her son, Tuanza, in the attack. She said, we welcomed you Wednesday night in our Bible study with open arms. You have killed some of the most beautifulest people that I know. Every fiber in my body hurts, and I'll never be the same. Tuanza is my hero, Felicia said. But then, even she showed kindness to the man accused of killing her son. She said, as we said in the Bible study, we enjoyed you, but may God have mercy on you. Dylan Roof Roof's public defender released a statement from Roof's family, offering prayers and sympathy for the victims, and expressing shock, grief, and disbelief as to what happened that night. The essence of theologian Herbert McCabe said it this way: the essence of the gospel is that if you don't love, you're dead, and if you do, they'll kill you. If you want a quiet life, a life of peace and contentment, then don't follow Jesus. If you want a totally secure life, a life lived within the margins of safety, then don't follow Jesus. If you want a life that is all mapped out, a life you can control and plan, then don't follow Jesus. Faith, you see, is not harbor hugging. Rather, it's more like bungee jumping. From an evolutionary perspective, the more risks we take, the more likely we are to survive and thrive. From a faith perspective, life's ultimate risk is not to risk anything. Today is Father's Day. It's also VBS kickoff day and Vacation Bible School staff commissioning. It is the Mexico Mission Team sending day. It's also the dedication of these beautiful quilts crafted by our quilters to go to the Mexican Mission families for whom homes will be built next week. With each of these events today, we are asking for God's strength, love, and joy to be with us as we live in Jesus' name. We are also asking that God's love will make a difference in the lives we touch for Jesus. As long as we are in the boat with Jesus, the Apostle Paul says that, quote, nothing will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Romans 8:39. He also said, in fact, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. Philippians 1:21. And he says, I would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. 2 Corinthians 5:8. When we're in the boat with Jesus, it all will come out right in the end.
Thank you.
trusting the Spirit's power, we pray for the church, the world, and all of God's creation. O God, you call your church through the waters of baptism. Give courage to those who lead us through word and sacrament, witness, service, and song. Strengthen all the baptized for lives of service in Christ's name. Hear us, O God.
Hear us, God.
You nourish the waters of creation. We pray for oceans and rivers, streams and lakes. Grant us wisdom as we care for life-giving waters. Hear us, O God.
Hear us, God.
You pilot the nations. Direct all leaders in the daily tasks of listening and speaking. Bring peace to all people and places afflicted by war, violence, disaster, and injustice. Hear us, O God.
Hear us, God.
You soothe our fearful hearts. Comfort those who grieve, those who are lost, those who doubt, and those who are sick, especially those we now name.
We pray for Joanne Stair and her family as they mourn the passing of her sister Helen. We pray for Reagan and Don, Joyce, Mickey, Len, Terry, Dave, Paul and Gail, Susan, Sandy, Joyce, Marie, Shirley, Mary, Barbara, Betty, Bonnie, Sherry. And for those of our loved ones serving in the military, Jake, Jordan, Robert, Matthew, Nathan, and Chris. And for friends and family of our members, for Amy, for Sherry, co-worker of Irene Owski, newly diagnosed with breast cancer, for Gary, Mike and Judy, Bill, Mitch, Larry, Barbara, Fred, Bailey Ruth, Susan, Deborah, Lori, Jim, Jean, Nikki, Dave, Ray, Dave, Kurt, Heather, Bill, Lois, Fred, Audrey, Dolores, and Kathy.
Give faith in the midst of all that troubles your people. Hear us, O God. You protect and guide the human family. Supply wisdom and energy to those who nurture children, especially fathers and mentors. Hear us, O God.
We pray for the Emmanuel AME Church in Charleston, that in the midst of death and violence, they may continue to show God's peace and respond with Jesus' love. We pray for Dylan Storm Roof, that he may be turned from hatred and fear and wrong thinking to discover the love God has for all people, even him. We give thanks for the Lutheran team and all of the volunteers that are ready to bless our children this week in Vacation Bible School. Bless all of their efforts as they all help our kids discover anew what really matters. And bless these beautiful quilts, which have been lovingly made by our quilters. The families in Tijuana who receive them may know the care and love of your people for one another. Hear us, O God.
Hear us, God.
For what else do the people of God pray?
Jim Martin,
Robert,
Margaret,
Hear us, O God.
Hear our prayer.
You give thanks for the saints. We give thanks for the saints. Make us attentive to your voice in this life, and grant us eternal peace in the life to come. Hear us, O God.
Hear our prayer.
Receive these prayers, gracious God, and those prayers known only to you. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Would you share a sign of peace as we wish? One of these this morning. Probably fell out on the floor, right? It's supposed to do that. Did you know that? We designed them specially. We put slippery stuff right on them so that when you open it, it goes right down on the floor. There's a reason for that. It's so that you can remember if you have anything, whether it's a prayer request, you put your name on the date on the front and write it on the back. And if you have a new, if you have a new address, write it down. If you have a new email, please write it down. If you have a new phone number, please write it down. We really rely on these. And Jeremy has an announcement.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My announcement is about the table you all probably saw on your way in. The youth are doing the stock donation fundraiser again, and we're almost to our goal. The stock, if you weren't here last time, is for the Detroit trip for the youth, and it's all going towards their enjoyment of the trip, as well as just getting them there, the plane tickets, the hotel, everything, and we really appreciate all of your donations, as well as it was brought up in a question at first service. If you perhaps slipped a check already into the offering, or you already slipped a check like last week and you don't have the ability to give again this week, you can come talk to me and we can get you the appropriate number of stock. And with the stock, depending if you want to give a just flat donation or if you want the stock option, we have the postcard, we have a handmade invitational letter, we have reserved seating, and the invitation goes to the benefactor's dinner, and so we really appreciate all the donations. And yeah.
How many kids will there be in Detroit?
In Detroit, we're going to have 7 people total, 5 kids and 2 chaperones, and in Detroit total, they estimate around 40,000 kids.
Thank you very much. Are there any other announcements before I have one?
Yes. We just had a request for funds from you generously, and here's another one. There's going to be a delicious barbecue and potluck after the service today, and there is some material, some food left over from another event that was provided by Thriving Financial. And that food is being made available for the potluck today at no cost to the church. But in return, we would appreciate if you could dig beyond the money that you're going to give to the youth, down a little deeper, and find a few dollars for the Helping Hands for Nepal. So this will be one more appeal for them. And Bev Questad will be here to answer any questions you may have. Do you want to say something now, Bev?
Well, this special appeal is going to go directly to a woman who has lost her two children and her husband and her house and all of her belongings. And so I leave on Thursday. I'm going to take it directly to her, and that's our target for this offer.
And that's to Nepal, right?
Yes.
Thank you. Well, we have Theo, Meg, Jordan, and Nate. We're going to present a song. Is it okay if we receive the offer during the song?
VBS is starting, so please keep VBS in your prayers for what matters most this week. Not only our four Lutherwood staff, but all the kids and volunteers that are going to be helping. And if you did take one of the cards, please make sure you get the items to the church now. And then come and eat food with us after the service. And that would be great. Thank you.
Thanks.
who, living among us, healed the sick, fed the hungry, and with a love stronger than death, gave his life for others. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took the bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life-giving death and glorious resurrection, we await, O God, your promised life for all this dying world. Breathe your Spirit on us and on this bread and cup. Carry us in your arms from death to life, that we may live as your chosen ones, clothed in the righteousness of Christ.
Amen.
So in confidence we pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the gift of his body and blood strengthen, keep, and unite us now and forever.
Amen.
Wise and generous God, we thank you that at this holy table you have fed us again with the food of everlasting life. Send us with your blessings to seek the good of our neighbor and call others to your peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Ascending Litany. Let us pray for our brothers and sisters who are leaving this week on their mission of building low-cost housing in Mexico. God, our protector, keep them safe in their travels and their work, that they might return to us with healthy bodies and grateful spirits.
Amen.
O Christ, keep their eyes open and their minds alert to the ways in which they will meet you in the people and events they will encounter.
Hear us, O Lord.
Spirit of life, stir up in them the strength to give and the openness to receive as they carry out this mission.
Hear us, O Lord.
In their going out and their coming in.
Be with them.
In their work and their rest.
Bless them.
In their conversation and their travels.
Be with them.
By night and by day.
Be their strength and their holy rest.
These loved ones we entrust to your care, O Lord, knowing that you walk with them in love. In Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
With those of you who are going to the Mexico mission, would you hold your hands up, please? We can call. Kathy's fallen.
Yeah.
Would you say a word of encouragement to them as they go as well? Receive the benediction. May the God of all hope and joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And remember, after the service ends, we're pushing all the pews back into the walls. So those of you who can stay and help are welcome to do that.
I'm so glad. serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.